Ladies and gentlemen, what is up, guys? Pro Player Apathy back today with a new YouTube video. And we're going to be doing a video that I did at the start of the game. We're going to be talking about the five most OP things that pro players do now. A new and updated one. A lot has changed since the game has been released. There's new movement, new mechanics, new things that pro players are doing. And today, I'm going to be giving you guys some amazing and really insightful tips for you guys to help you guys become a better player, a more dominant player, and so you can destroy all your school friends and destroy everyone you want to destroy, and so you can be the best player you can be. And if you want to be a pro player, like a top amateur player, well, this will help too, of course. So let's get right into it. Hope you guys really enjoyed this new video. Hope you guys enjoy it a lot, man. So for first thing we're going to be talking about is sniking headies. Now, what do I mean by headies? Headies aka means head glitches. What are head glitches? Anything that you can only see your head on. So for example, this is a head glitch. This is like a head glitch, but not the best head glitch because your body pokes out a little bit more. Obviously, there's good head glitches and there's god head glitches. So what is snaking? Well, snaking is basically going up and down behind an object where it's very difficult for them to shoot you. So you can do it like proning like this. This is technically what snaking is. Now, this is very cheesy, very broken mechanic. I guess pro players don't care and everyone pretty much does it nowadays. So it's becoming a very popular thing, but it is very cheap, especially with these, online being a thing, and with these 12 hertz private lobbies, really ruins the game and makes snaking so effective and cheap because it's just so hard to react when, you know, they're popping up and see you first before you can see them. So it's basically just doing this over and over again or crouching behind. The point of this tip number one is we're not going to be talking about actual snaking and doing this over and over again because this is pretty cheesy. I don't want you guys to really be spamming this. So basically what you wouldn't want to do is you're going to want to slide cancel. So you're going to slide cancel into the head glitch. So let's say I want to snake this head glitch. I'm going to back up and then I'm going to slide cancel the head glitch and do this and pop up. So in Black Ops 4, this was pretty popular. This game, it wasn't that popular until basically slide canceling became a thing. And I'll be talking about slide canceling and how to slide cancel later on this video. I did a tutorial video about a week ago talking about it. So if you didn't watch that, well, you can learn in this video as well. I'll do a quick recap on it. Let's say this is a head glitch. You want to just do this and just slide cancel into it. And pro players will do this. They will slide cancel, not see anything, run back. Slide cancel again, not see anything, run back. Slide cancel again until they basically cheese you because it's that broken. So obviously you guys know about snaking head glitches, about slide canceling, hell of a head glitch. But now we're going to be talking about something a lot of pro players I don't think do yet. And this is a pretty cool tip. And obviously I'll be sharing it with you guys because I want you guys to get better. And pro players eventually will get the hang of this as well. But so this, like lower headies, right? These headies that are really difficult, that they don't really head glitch you much. Like your body pokes out if you crouch. It definitely is a lot better if you crouch. So there's also a way to slide cancel if you just do slide, right? It leaves you in a crouch state, right? As you can see, it's like kind of like a crouch state. It leaves you crouched. So there's a lot of head glitches like this in the game. They're like mid head glitches, like little ones that your body basically is exposed a lot. So all these headies, like on this map, there are these two. There's not a lot of them, but there are those exact head glitches on every map. So what you want to do is you want to slide, not slide cancel. You just want to slide into the headie, which is like a mini slide cancel. So you basically want to do this, and it leaves you in a crouch state, and you're basically essentially head glitching now a smaller headie. And it's really effective in all these little headies. So you see how my body barely peeks out? Like, if my body's like this, he has an easy side on me. But since I'm doing the slide, it peeks out really little. Tip number two, we're going to be talking about how to slide cancel. First things first, you want to go to your options. You want to put your slide behavior on tap. Now, I use R3 to slide. So I slide once, it basically does a long slide. If I want to cancel the slide, I have to press R3 again. So this is basically R3, slide, R3, slide, R3, slide. So I'm basically canceling it before it goes the full way, because you can click it once, it'll go all the way until you decide to stop it. So clicking it the second time basically is when you want to stop it, where you want to stop it. So I could just slide, automatically cancel the slide. So it's like a little animation like this. So I could do a short slide like this, or I could do a longer slide like this. Now, once you have it on tap, and once you understand that R3 is the slide, and you want, that's how you're gonna cancel your slide. Now you're gonna use an X. So basically you're gonna slide X, which X for me is jump. So you're gonna be basically slide jump, and then obviously you can aim in, slide jump aim in, shoot, aim jump in. And it's literally in order. You're gonna hit R3, jump, and then aim in, and then shoot. That's literally the order you want to be doing it. Slide aim in, shoot, And you can even do a slide hip fire. So it's basically another way of engaging. You don't always have to aim in. Come around this corner, slide, cancel, slide, cancel, hip fire. And it does work really well with MP5, especially if you're running the Merc foregrip, because it's just so freaking good. So it does take a little bit of practice getting used to it, especially if you're not really good with movement. So the next thing we're going to be talking about is cammering. Cameras. Yes, the cheesy little cheap thing that everyone does nowadays and have been doing it for years. And it's really broken because online is a factor. And these damn 12 hertz, 20 hertz lobbies, whatever, it's a big problem. It's not as bad on land, but it still is pretty bad, and you can still camera pretty much anytime. So camera is basically breaking the cameras in the game and seeing your opponent a split second before they see you. And that works by going around a corner really fast, or jumping around a corner really fast, or like slide canceling around a corner really fast. And basically, you are going to be able to have the advantage. A split second, you're going to be able to shoot first. And they're just not going to be able to react most of the time. You're going to basically have a free kill. Obviously, you can camera with the slide cancel. I come around a corner like this. This is a good way of cameraing people. They basically are dead every time. You have a free kill on them. If you come around the corner like this, slide canceling, it is literally a free kill. That guy is dead 9.5 out of 10 times, unless he somehow world stars you. Another way to camera is bunny hopping, or just simply hopping around a corner. So you could just do a double attack sprint. Wait, 4 bullets. That's all I needed, baby. So you could do a double attack sprint like this, and then chow out. Double attack sprint, chow out. Double attack sprint, chow out. You could do just a regular hop like this, like a one hop. Simply like obviously around a corner. The double attack sprint is faster though, so I think it's better. I think it's best. And then you can also do the bunny hop. Now the bunny hop takes a little bit of practice getting used to. It's basically you aim in and you jump as soon as you land on the floor. So like that. Now that's not the best one. You could do a little bit better. I don't really bunny hop that much anymore. I slide cancel more than I bunny hop. Bunny hop has died out a little bit, especially on submachine guns. It's just all about timing. And since my timing is kind of off with it now, I'm just really good slide canceling. I mess it up a decent amount, but basically you're going to jump, double attack sprint, jump, and then aim in. And as soon as you're about to hit the floor, you jump again. So like that. And that was like, these are like average bunny hops. Like that was a little bit better one. But when you get really good with it, then you start hitting some godlike bunny hops. Like your opponent is like, damn, I didn't even get a chance to react. Like you just flew across the screen. So essentially that's how you camera. Just coming around a corner really fast, just slide canceling, bunny hopping. And it's just so hard, especially online. And like I said, with these damn low hertz lobbies, for anyone to do anything. And every pro player abuses them because it's just so freaking good. Tip number 4. We're going to be talking about pre-aiming only on head glitches and off angles. Now, a lot of players tend to do this, especially more of the noobier players. And this is a really bad habit that you guys should get rid of. Whenever you're pre-aiming something, you never, first of all, number one mistake, you never want to pre-aim out in the open like this. Now, the only time you should ever pre-aim out in the open is if you're holding an off angle. So an angle where even if a guy comes around a corner, let's say this is a head-on angle, right? If a guy comes around a corner right here, I'm probably dead. But let's say I hold a weird angle, like sort of like an off angle diagonal angle like this. There's a good chance I'm gonna kill that guy. There's a couple reasons why he is dead. Number one, he has to recenter on me. So now he's gonna be like, oh shit, he's here. So now he has to aim here. When pro player center, we're always usually on our target. So we're running around here. We're always on our target. And when a guy is not on our actual target coming around a corner, now we have to recenter. And that little split second, or that half a second of recentering, could get you killed. Number two, when he comes around this corner, he is already exposing his body challenge here. But if you have an off angle, or let's say a wider angle, you are essentially gonna see him coming around the corner a little bit earlier than he would have thought. It's a simple angle adjustment, you know. Like if I'm holding an angle here, obviously I can only see him if he comes here. Now if I'm holding angle like this, now if he peeks, even just like if he peeks his body, I'm gonna see him faster than I would have here. It's simple mathematics, guys. So that is usually the only time you should ever hold the pre-aim is during an off angle when you're not on a head glitch. Now, you remember what I talked about, guys? Crouch, head glitch it with a crouch state. Yup, you're learning. Obviously, when you're in head glitches, pre-aims are usually okay. In Call of Duty, especially in this game, you only ever want to pre-aim when you're on a head glitch. So you're on a head glitch. This is a nice head glitch right here. On a head glitch, I could pre-aim this. I could pre-aim here. I'm a head glitch. If he comes around the corner, I'm totally fine. He has to world star you. He has to absolutely obliterate your head to kill you. Right here, good spot. Nice head glitch. I can pre-aim. I can challenge someone. Just take my time. Now, like this on the open, well, there's a good chance I'm going to die. This is just like a 30, 70, 40, 60 The odds are just not in my favor. But when you're on head glitches, you want to pre-aim. Tip number five, and the last tip for you guys, another pro tip for all you beautiful, amazing people. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I welcome all you amazing new people, but let's get right into it. We're going to be talking about controlling the recoil. Now, every gun has a different recoil pattern. I think one thing pro players are really good is understanding the recoil pattern early and then sort of mastering the gun. Obviously, there's like 2-3 best guns in every game. Pro players use those guns. We understand the pattern really quick. We grind with the gun. We understand sort of how to control the recoil. It becomes muscle memory. If you were to shoot an MP5 straight at a wall, look how it would recoil. Does it shoot completely straight? No, it has like weird little angles. Does it shoot pretty up? It does shoot pretty up with these attachments. So it's good. It's not that difficult to adjust. Oh, get smoked, the bot. So to go a little bit more in depth, this shoots pretty much up for the most part with these attachments. So what do? As I'm shooting people, I simply have to hold down my analog stick. I don't really want to hold it hard, but I'm just going to see that's what happens when you hold it hard. So I'm just going to hold it slowly low. And as you can see, it's pretty much in the center of my opponent, of the area I want to target my enemy. So you guys once again, goes up pretty much. When it recoils like this, I mean, that's pretty simple. You just want to hold down your analog stick a bit. Control the spray. As you can see, it's pretty much in the center of a guy's stomach or chest, either or. I mean, whatever you want to say. So pretty much when I play, like, I automatically slightly shoot and I lower my stick. It's just a habit. It's a muscle memory thing. I don't completely just let it go. Like, I try to control the recoil. I try to control the stick. And that's why I'm able to beam people and shoot people from really far away and hit almost every shot. It does take a lot of practice and getting used to really, like, be that precise. And, you know, a lot of time and effort. But once you get there, like, there's no one stopping you. Not even me. Let me be honest. So I really recommend you checking whatever gun you like to use, or if you use an MP5 or an M4 and really getting used to the recoil pattern. You can do this simply just by shooting a wall, figuring it out, like, okay, let's say this thing shot a little bit more to the right. Let's say it shot like this. It's like, okay, it shoots up and right. So what do I got to do? I got to shoot low and left. So my goal while I'm shooting it is going to be low and left. And you gotta, but it's not a huge adjustment. You don't just freaking yank it down, obviously. You're gonna wanna control it. You're gonna do subtle little movements to really control that recoil and keep that in the steady circle. So I hope you guys enjoyed this new in-depth video. Top 5 things that pro players abuse and use, and just broken OP things. Things that, you know, I might have brought up a long time ago, maybe, but a couple new things as well. And things that will make you a better player once you really master these things and apply it to your gameplay. You know, I'm always here for you guys. Trying to show some tips, trying to share with you guys my knowledge, trying to help you guys get better. You know, I've been there before. I've been there at the start, and it ain't easy. So I'm just trying to help whatever I can. If you learned something in this video and it really helped you out, make sure to leave a thumbs up. Let's aim for like 500 likes. That'd be nice. Hope you all have a wonderful day. Subscribe to the channel for more tip videos and some amazing gameplay. I'll see you guys later. I'm out.